Okay, today we're going to be replacing the cylinder lock on the ignition on a 92 F-150. This should be the same for a 92 to 95, I believe, F-150s and Broncos. And I think before and after there was a different lock design. The reason why I'm replacing mine is if you look at this, it just no key in it, it just spins. This isn't connected any longer to the cylinder lock itself, and it causes the door chime to come on when it, it doesn't need to. And I got the new cylinder lock from Advance Auto, and it was $10 after online discount. Comes with two keys, and it says that you can just slide it right in, basically. First thing you got to do is there's a cover underneath, and it's two screws, so you got to remove this whole cover here. Now I have tilt steering wheel, so on the other side there's the lever. Where are you? Right here. Yeah, just unscrew this. Okay, just unscrew it and take the two screws out. All right, I'll pop the cover off and I'll show you what we get. All right, I got the cover off. Okay, and it was actually three screws instead of just two, so just be aware. Okay, next, under the cylinder lock, there's a small little pin you have to push. I can't show you with the lighting or the way the camera is here on the one that's in there, but on the new one, you'll see. Okay, that's the new one, and you're gonna see that pin. See that right there? Okay, right there, that round circle. You're going to end up having to push that in, and what I'm going to use is a little Allen key that's just the right size for that. So I'm going to go underneath the one that's in there, hit the pin, and it should slide right out. Okay, I've read some different stuff about removing this, and it says a lot of places I read that you have to have the key to run in order to have it slide out. So we'll try that. I got my Allen key. Find the pin. Push in the pin. And it slides right out. Perfect. Now, the only problem is I did not disconnect the battery. So I actually have to get the new one in because the truck thinks it's on right now. Okay, just finished installing the newer one. And as you can see, the two keys are still there, but I chose a black one so it blended in a little bit better. Just a little darker. I like that look. Now, the problem I did have is at first, when I put it in there, I made sure that the key was left alone. It came with a warning on the box to not turn the key until after you have the new lock installed. Okay, so I got the new lock in, and at first, I thought I'd gotten the wrong length of cylinder lock somehow because it didn't feel like it was going in all the way like it should. It wasn't flush like it is now, but eventually I played with it. I almost panicked for a second because then I couldn't get it out. But once I got it in right, it works perfectly. Okay, I don't have the battery hooked up right now because I ended up unhooking it halfway through. And you can see it turns just the way it should. And this, take the key out, this isn't loose anymore, just like it was 20 years ago. Perfect. All right, well, I'm glad that came out a little easier than it did going in, but it still worked okay. Okay, good luck. Hope this helped.